Hello everyone, this is Shashank. I hope you all are doing well today. So today we are going to learn something about simple notification service provided by Amazon as part of an application integration module. So if you go to the services section and inside application integration, you will gonna find SNS. So by name it suggests why we need to use SNS. So basically it's a push-based mechanism where we push the notification when any kind of event happens. So when I say any kind of event happen, what does that mean? So let's say we are uploading object to our S3 bucket. So that is kind of an uploading event. We'll get notified to our email. Let's say your EC2 instance is stopped suddenly. So that is also another kind of event. So at least we'll get notified by an alert. Same with the other resources that we have in AWS, because SNS has a integration with all other services in AWS. This is region specific. So if you're provisioning SNS in Northern Virginia, this will not gonna work in Ohio, okay? The most important aspect is highly available, durable, and secure. So the notification sent over the network or between the resources, that is basically secure. It's private and secure. And this is fully managed AWS service. Okay. So this is the basic idea behind creation of an SNS topic. So basically topics are the message channel or the container where you push the messages to all the subscribers that we have inside that channel. So, and again, I'll take an example, a short example, a basic example where I'm uploading an event or sorry, and uploading an object to S3 bucket, okay? But on a weekly basis, let's say I'm not sure if my data is getting uploaded successfully every week or not. I just want to get notified whenever my objects gets uploaded to S3 bucket. So which service which I'll gonna use? It's SNS, as simple as that. There are multiple protocols supported with SNS, which we're gonna see while configuring the SNS topic. So to do the practical demo, we have to create a topic first. So for that, click next. You have to give the topic name. Let's say test SNS. And I'm gonna use the same for display name. So we have an option, certain option while doing the configuration. If you want to encrypt your response in transit, then you can enable the encryption. For doing the encryption, you have to use custom master KMS key. Again, KMS is a key management service used for encryption and decryption. So if you're not aware of what KMS is all about, please do watch my KMS video. That will give you a clear picture how the encryption and decryption mechanism happens. So with this particular video, I'm not gonna send out any encrypted method of transmission. So basically I'll check the disable encryption, which is by default with this option. Okay, it's just a test message to my email. Access policy, there are two, basic and advanced. Advanced, you can write down your JSON script and just place it in this particular box with actions and on which resource you are going to do that. So that is advanced. So I don't have any JSON format written as of now. So I'm gonna use basic. In basic, we have two different options. Who can publish the message? It's a topic owner, everyone, or specified AWS account. So here you can give your account number. So I'm gonna use everyone and who can subscribe to this topic. Again, I'm gonna use everyone. The next point is retry policy. So by default, three retries will gonna happen, and after third retry for sending a message, you will get an alert that retry got failed. If you want to modify this, uncheck this box and you can modify the number. Again, minimum delay is 20 seconds and maximum delay is 20 seconds. That is by default. The requirement varies from company to company. So this can be get modified, right? And the last, not the last, the status logging basically. So what kind of delivery log delivery status you want to have for these protocols? Lambda, SQS is another service from application integration, which we're gonna cover in another video. HTTP, HTTPS protocol, and endpoint. So I'm gonna check everyone. So again, requirement depends from one person to another person. So based upon that, you can select it. So to create SNS topic and to publish the message, you need some permissions. So for permission, you need to know about IAM role. So role is basically a principal or a user to access one service to another service. So obviously, to access one service to another service, you need to have some permission. So for that, we create role, which is based upon IAM. I don't have any existing role, so I'm gonna create a new one, I guess. So, yep, I don't remember if I have an existing role, so that's why I'm creating a new one. So for that, click on create a new service role, click create new. This will gonna open my IAM console, which will gonna ask me about creation of the role. So I'm gonna do create role, let's say 2. As I said, I don't remember if I have or not, so I'm just placing a number. Now, the policy document, again, policy at the set of permissions which you defined. So if you're not aware of the IAM role and policies, how permissions are defined, please do watch my IAM video series as well. So basically, it's an effect of allow. We are creating a log group, log stream, put the log events, metric filter, and retention policy on resource star, which is everything. The same thing I'll gonna do for failure feedback, number 2, and click allow. This has created my roles. So the role has been created. This is the ARN for success, and this is the ARN for failure. Again, ARN are the unique identifiers, which basically segregate one resource to another resource. So whenever you create any resource in AWS, you will get a unique identifier as an ARN. Last is tagging, which is optional again, but very important. So I'm gonna name this as test SNS, and I'll create a topic. My topic is created, and you can see we have certain options over here, which we have already defined. Access policy, retry policy, status logging, encryption, and tagging. The next step is to push messages, as SNS is a push mechanism. So for that, we have to create some subscription. Okay, so to create subscription, you have to click create subscription. We have the topic ARN, and these are the protocols supported by SNS, HTTP or HTTPS as an endpoint, email, you can send out an email, email JSON, SQS, Lambda, you can integrate with Lambda to trigger the notification, then application endpoint, and SMS. So for this particular video, I'm gonna use email because I don't have any endpoint created. So for that, I'm gonna use my channel email ID. And you can filter out the messages that you want to send it to the subscribers. Okay, now last option is to create subscription, and you will get status as pending confirmation. So the endpoint is my email ID. So let's go to our email ID. We have received an email from test SNS. So here it's asking for confirmed subscription. Click on that. This will give you a data that subscription has been confirmed, and this is the ID for subscription. And if you want to unsubscribe, click here. Okay, so we have already subscribed it. Let's go to our AWS console. Go to the topic, and here we can see like we have a status change to confirm for this particular subscription. The last step is to send out a message, publish message. So for that, you have to be in topic, click on publish message. Subject line is optional, but I'm gonna give test SNS, time to live. You can give in number of seconds, because the number of seconds to push the notification service, I would say 3 seconds. And here you can give the message. This is my first SNS topic. attributes for the messages, you can do like string, string array, number, or binary. So click on publish message. Let's see. So message published to the topic test is successfully. So let's go to our email ID again to verify if we have received something or not. Here we go. We have received a mail with body line as this is my first SNS topic and subject line as test SNS. So this is the way how we configure SNS topic in our AWS management console. So just give it a try, create a topic, create a subscription, push the message. If you have endpoint, then use HTTP or HTTPS as well. Or if you have an application endpoint, try to create with that protocol and publish the messages. That's it, guys, for this particular video. So if you have any concern to create a topic, to configure a topic, place out a comment in comment section of this video and I'll be there to help you right away. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.